Good evening, everybody. My presentation topic is indexing and caching of US-based geothermal data. So the first question comes to our mind with the term geothermal data. So what's that? Geothermal data refers to the heat energy emitted from the Earth's surface. It might be in the form of hot rocks, hot water, or even shallow earth. There are more than 35 US geothermal data available, features available in the United States. USGEN is a massive catalog of geothermal data. It refers to basically millions of US-based geothermal features, which are metadata and in the form of web feature services get capabilities URLs. The basic purpose to develop a USGEN repository was to provide a platform for the interested folks. It may include geothermal industry, policymakers, students, or web developers. Here is the overview of my presentation. I will start with objectives, then I will discuss about the data sets available. Then I will talk about the technologies I have adopted to complete the project. Then I will discuss about the methodologies and the procedures I have adopted to complete the project. After that, I will discuss results, and then I will go to conclusions and give credits to my project. So, index and cache the geothermal data. The basic objective of our project was to index and cache the geothermal data into a non-SQL database. Why we choose a non-SQL database? Because it is document-based. It takes much less resources than traditional SQL database. And our next objective was to facilitate the users with an open source, interactive, publicly available map so that the geothermal data should be available to them whenever they want with a 0 second response time. That web application provide thematic and special search to its users. USGEN repository host catalog services for web. So what's the catalog services for web? It is a metadata that contains information about all those features. These are geothermal features available within the United States. It includes abandoned mines, active faults, aqueous chemistry, borehole temperatures, direct use features, and so on. Here are the technologies I have used to complete the project. The coding of the project is done in Node.js. Node.js is an open source server-side JavaScript library. Actually, it supports dozens of APIs. Then I used Geospatial Data Abstraction Library. It actually converts the web feature services that are in XML format to the GeoJSON format. So once the features are converted to the GeoJSON format, I save them into the MongoDB, and after they're saving them into the MongoDB, I index those features into the Elasticsearch. And after indexing of the features in the Elasticsearch, I use the leaflet-based plugin available for Elasticsearch, which is written in AngularJS, to set up a web mapping application. So here is the methodology I have adopted to complete the project. Application request catalog services for web hosted at USGEN repository. In response, the repository returns the XML features that are in get capabilities format URLs. Then my application modifies those get capability URLs to get feature requests that are made to the server that request the web feature services hosted by the 50 geological services and at other educational resources sites. In returns, I get the XML feature files. I pass those XML features file through the mapping function to remove the redundancy of the data and remove the unnecessary attributes from the data. I use GDAL library here to convert the XML features into the GeoJSON one. And once the features are converted into the GeoJSON format, I save those files into the MongoDB. After saving them in the MongoDB, I extract the GeoJSON features from those files and index them into the Elasticsearch. Once the data get indexed into the Elasticsearch, I customize AngularJS based Elasticsearch web plugin to show that all those features on the map. I use the GeoHash functionality of the Elasticsearch to display those million of features point on the map. So here it is how data looks in the Elasticsearch. I query the all the data features and they are almost 3.1 million in total. They could be more, but the services were not available. I'm still working on that part. We can perform all the arithmetic operation, aggregation operations on the data available like we do into the SQL based databases. Like here I query the database to get me the borehole temperature where the depth equals to 1281 and it returns me those two records. Then I query the database to give me the borehole temperatures where depth ranges between 20,000 to 30,000 and it returns me 580 records. From here, I will like to demonstrate that web mapping application. Here is the main face of the application. The user can select the feature type whatever he wants to. I choose borehole temperatures for now. So the data has been clustered into the GeoHash format because it is easy when you drill down the features, you can get more details about them. At a certain level, you can get the individual features. So it gives you with an idea that exactly where the feature exists in the United States and what kind of features are available. You can also query within the files document, or you can query with the numeric operations as well. For example, I query the map to give me the borehole temperatures where depth ranges between 10,000 to 20,000. And while you look at the statistics, those are 753 features available on the map that satisfy this condition. You can also change the range values. For example, I choose from give me the borehole temperature where the depth lies between 20,000 to 30,000 meters. This time it returns 580 features, and now you can check here are the borehole temperature where the depth is between 20,000 and 30,000. You can also search within the text documents like I put the string that only give me the feature that lies within the Pima County of Arizona State. So it narrows down your search and you will get the features that exist only in the Pima County. There are other options available in this web mapping application that you can change the base map. You can choose to change your map display with a heat map, so you are able to have a good idea with the intensity of the features available on the map. You can change the opacity of the heat map. So back to the presentation. One more feature I forget to mention is that you are able to download the results in the CSV format. So the results are, this web mapping application, NGDS application, provides us a centralized platform to access, to have an access all of the national geothermal data systems. The data has been indexed into the Elasticsearch, so the when you query the data, it returns you the results within milliseconds. So there is no time delay. The application is publicly accessible, and it provides a platform to the interested audience to perform analysis on the data. And as it is an open source project, so there is a GitHub repository of the project where the other folks interested in the source code able to download the data and modify it according to their own needs. So in the conclusions, we can easily say that the application has low latency and high performance. The application is highly scalable. Big data stored in the document format, and it is available for searching purpose. Search is performed within the large documents, and it provides NGD resources for policymakers, students, and researchers. I would like to pay special thanks to my managers at Arizona Geological Survey and folks at GIST program. They helped me throughout my degree program, so that it's all because of them that I'm standing here today.